Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class we had started with a new chapter, that is multiplication and division, correct? So in the last class we just did revision on what you all have learned in multiplication last year and in division also last year. So we saw that multiplication is nothing but it is repetitive addition. It is called as repetitive addition. What is division? Division is splitting into equal parts or groups. So when you have some number of things, so when you want to divide them equally, you use division to split them into equal groups or parts. Okay, so that is division. Today's class will start with multiplication. Okay, so we saw what are the multiplication properties last time. So you have two numbers, whenever you change the order of the two numbers, the product will remain the same. That is one property. And if you have three numbers, you have to multiply. When you multiply the three numbers in any order, the product remains the same. Okay, also whenever you multiply a number by one, the answer is the number itself. Same way, when you multiply a number with zero, the answer is zero only. So these are the four main properties of multiplication. Alright, so today we'll start with multiplication. So what is multiplication? The number in multiplication, the number which is being multiplied is called the multiplicand. Okay, it is called the multiplicand. The number by which it is multiplied is called the multiplier. So the answer obtained is known as the product. The answer that you obtain is called the product. So what is multiplicand? The number which is being multiplied. Then the number by which it is multiplied is called the multiplier, and the number obtained is known as the product. So what's key? For example, I'll tell 5 into 6. How much is 5 into 6? It is 30. 5, 6 are 30. So here 5 is the number that is being multiplied. So it is the multiplicand. 6 is the number it is being multiplied with. So 6 is the multiplier and 30 is the answer. So that is the product. Okay, so these are the terms used in multiplication. So first we'll study one digit multipliers. Okay, so in one digit multipliers, what you do, we just multiply each digit of the multiplicand with the single digit multiplier. Okay, if the value of any place exceeds 9, it is regrouped and carried over to the higher place. Okay, just like addition, when a value of a place exceeds 9, we carry it over to the next place. So that is how you do in multiplication also. So here find the product 215 into 4. So first we'll write 215 here like this in its place. So 5 is in 1's place, 1 is in 10's place, 2 is in 100's place. Then we'll multiply it by 4. So how do we multiply? First we'll multiply 4 with 1's. So in 1's we have 5. So 4 5's is how much? It is 20. Now it is exceeding 9. So we'll write 0 here and carry over 2 to 10's place. Okay, then we'll multiply 4 with 1. So 4 1's is how much? 4 1's is 4 only. And then we'll add this 2 which we have carried over. So 4 1's are 4 plus 2, 6. So we'll write 6 here. Then we'll do 4 into 2. 8. How much is 4 2's? 4 2's is 8. So we'll write down 8. So 860 is the answer. So what are the steps? First we'll do 5 1's into 4 1's. We'll get 20 1's. So we regroup, write 0 1's and carry over 2 10's. Okay, then we do 1 10 which is there here into 4. So we'll get 4 10's. So 4 10's plus 2 10's is 6 10's. So we write 6 here. Then we do 200s here into 4, that is 800. So we write 8. So the answer is 215 into 4 is equal to 860. Okay, so that was one example. Then next example, find the product of 1308 into 7. So how do you do that? So first we'll write down 1308 in its place. So 8 is in 1, 0 in 10s, 3 in 100s and 1 in 1000s. Then we'll multiply 8 1s into 7. So 8 ones into 7 is 56 ones. So we'll write 6 ones and carry over 5 tens. Then we'll multiply 0 tens that is there here with 7. So 0 into 7 is how much? It is 0 only. Plus 5 is there here. So 0 plus 5, 5. So we'll write down 5 there. Then we do 300s into 7. So 300 into 7 is how much? It is 21. So we regroup, write 100 here and carry over 2000s like this. Okay, then we do 1 into 7. So 1 into 7 is 7 plus 2 which we have carried over is 9. So we'll write down 9. So 1308 into 7 is 9156. Okay, it is 9156. Now, so this is how you do multiplication by one digit multiplier. So let's solve the problems that are there in your textbook. So page number 116, exercise 3.1. Okay, and then first problem, 421 into 3. 421 into 3. So first we'll do 3 into 1. That is 1 ones into 3. So how much is 3 ones are? 3 ones are is 3 only. So we'll write down 3 here. So, okay, so we write down 3. Then we multiply 2 tens with 3. So 2 threes are is how much? 2 threes are is 6. That is 6 tens. We'll write 6 like this. Then 4 threes are or 3 fours are. How much is 3 fours are? It is 12. So we'll write 1. 2. So 4021 into 3 is 1263. So first what we did, we did 3 ones are 3, then we did 3 twos are 6, then we did 3 fours are 12. So that is 1263. Alright, now next one. 232 with 2. So 2 twos are 4. So first we'll multiply 2 twos are 4 and we'll write 4 here. Then we'll multiply 3 tens with 2. So 3 tens into 2 is 6 tens. So we'll write 6 in tens place. Okay, we'll write 6 here. Then 2 twos are 4, right? So 2 twos are is 4. So what is the answer? 232 into 2 is 6,464. So we did 2 twos are 4. Then 2 3s are 6 and then 2 2s are 4. So 464. Then 345 into 6. So first we multiply 6 into 5. How much is 6 5s are? 6 5s are is 30. So we'll write down 0 and carry over 3 to 10s place. Okay. Then 4 10s into 6. How much is 4 10s into 6 or 4 into 6? It is 24. 6 1s are 6. 6 2s are 12. 6 3s are 18 and 6 4s are 24. So 24 plus these 3 tens. So 24 plus 3 is 27. So we can't write 27 here. We'll write 7 and carry over 2 to 100's place. Then 6 3s are how much? 6 3s are is 18 and 18 plus 2 is 20. So we'll write down 20. So 345 with 6 is 2070. Okay, 2070. Next, 3547 into 3547 into 7. So how much is 7 7s are? 7 7s are is how much? It is 49. So we'll write down 9 and carry over 4. We'll carry over 4 to 10's place. Now, 4 tens into 7. 4 tens into 7 is how much? It will be 28. 4 sevens are 28. Plus, we have 4 which we have carried over. So, 28 plus 4 is how much? It is 32. So, we will write 2, carry over 3. Okay. Then, we will do 5 hundreds into 7. 7 fives are how much? 7 5s are is 35. Then plus 3 which we have carried over. 35 plus 3 is 38. So we'll write 8 carry over 3. Then 3 sevens is how much? 3 sevens is 21. 21 plus 3 is 24. Okay, 24. So we'll write down 24. So 3547 into 7 is 24,829. So what we did here? First we did 7 sevens are 49. We wrote 9, carried over 4. Then 7 fours are 28. 28 plus 4 we did 32. So we wrote 2, carried over 3 to hundreds place. Then 7 fives are 35 plus 3, 38. So we write 8 and carry over 3. Okay, then 7 threes are 21. 21 plus 3 is 24. So the answer is 24,829. Okay, so this was question number D. Now, moving on to question number E, 6524 multiplied by 5. So, 6524, here is a multiplicand, 5 is the multiplier. So, we'll do 4 ones into 5 first. So, 4 5s is how much? It is 20. So, we'll write down 0 and carry over 2 here. So, now we carried over 2, we'll do 2 tens into 5 first. So, 2 5s is 10. Plus 2 which we have carried over makes it 12. So we'll again carry over. So we'll write 2 here and regroup and carry over 1 to hundreds place. Now what we'll do, we'll multiply 5 hundreds with 5. So 5 5s is how much? It is 25. Plus 1, 26. So we write 6, carry over 1. So 5 6s is how much? 5 6s is 30. Plus 1 is 31. Okay, 31. So 6524 into 5 is 31,620. So let's do again. 5 4s are 20, write down 0, carry over 2. 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 2, 12. So 2 we write down, carry over 1. 5 5s are 25 plus 1, 26. So we write 6 and carry over 1. Then 5 6s are 30 plus 1 is 31. So 31,620. Alright, then last one, 1672 into 9. So what you do here, first we'll start multiplying 2 ones with 9. So how much is 2 into 9 or 9 into 2? 9 into 2 is 18. So we write 8, carry over 1. 7 nines are, how much is 7 nines are? 7 9s are 63. So 63 plus 1 is 64. So you write 4, carry over 1 to hundreds place. Then 9 6 is how much? 9 6 is 54. 54 plus 1 is 55. So 5, carry over 1. Then 9 1s are 9 plus 1 is 10. So we got 10,548. So first we'll do 2 1s into 9 which is 18. So write down 8, carry over 1. Then we'll do 7 10s into 9. So 7 10s into 9 is 63 plus 1 is 64. So we write down 4 and carry over 6 to hundreds place. Then 6 hundreds into 9. So 6 into 9, sorry. Let's do the last problem again. So 9 2s are 18, so we write down 8, carry over 1. So 9 7s are 63, so 63 plus 1 is 64. So we write down 4 here and carry over 6 to hundreds place, sorry. Then 9 6s are 54, correct, 6 9s are 54. So 54 plus 6 is how much? 54 plus 6 is 60. So we write down 0 and carry over 6. Okay, now 9 1s is how much? 9 1s are 9. 9 plus 6 is 15. So we'll write down 15 here. So 15,048 is the answer. Okay, so first we multiply the 1s. 2 9s are 18. Right? 8 carry over 1. Then we multiply the 10s. So 7 10s into 9 is 63 plus 1 is 64. So we write down 4 and carry over 6. Okay, then 9 6 are 54. So 54 plus 6 is 60. So we write down 0 and carry over 6. Okay, then what we do, we do 9 ones are 9 plus 6 is 15. So 1672 into 9 is 15,048. Okay, what's the answer? It is 15,048. So this is how you do multiplication by one digit multiplier. So for your homework, I will give you a few problems which you all can do. So you all can just do these five, six problems what I'm giving you all. So 259 into 6, then 1352 into 4, then 370 into 5, 125 into 7, and then 666 into 3. So do these five problems for homework in your books, and okay, do these five problems, and I will give you the answers for these problems in the next class. Okay, we'll continue in the next class with two digit multipliers. So today we did one digit multipliers. In the next class we will do two digit multipliers. All right, so copy down these questions, do these questions for homework, complete them and come. All right, and we'll continue in the next class. All right, students, thank you. I'll see you all in the next class. Do these five problems for homework and come. Okay, thank you.